students, I am Sheetal Chaudhary and today we are going to study class 12th accountancy chapter, that is admission of our partner. So before starting this chapter, we need to understand that what do you mean by admission of a partner. So let's take an example for this. Suppose there are two friends A and B who decided to start a business and they started a business. And they name their company as ABC Limited. So, they both A and B started a business or a company known as ABC Limited. Now, they both A and B want a new partner C to join their firm ABC Limited. When C will join their firm ABC Limited, it will be known as admission of a new partner. So what does admission of a partner basically means is when a new partner enter a firm. So this is admission of a partner. Now let's begin with the chapter and move on to next topic. So the next topic is why a new partner is needed into the business. Okay, so now we need to understand that why a new partner is needed. So there may be many reasons for which a new partner can be added. So let's begin with the reason that why a new partner is added. The first reason that a new partner can be added is capital. When more capital is required for the expansion of the business. Suppose let's take an example for this. A and B require more capital to expand their business, but they are not having enough money. Thus, they decided to admit C into partnership, who is having enough money. So that's why they admit C into their partnership. So the first reason for which a new partner can be added into partnership is capital. When the existing partners do not have enough money and they want more capital for the expansion, they can admit a new partner into their partnership or a firm. So let's begin with the second topic. What can be the other reasons for which a new partner can be added? The second reason can be competency. Suppose the existing partners want a competitive and experienced partner so that their enterprise can work more efficiently. So when a more competent or a experienced partner is required for the efficient working of the organization, then also a new partner can be admitted. So the second reason is competent partner or experienced person. This is the second reason for which a new person, a new partner can be added. So let's see the third reason for which a new partner can be added. The third reason can be goodwill of the firm. Suppose A and B want the goodwill of their company, ABC Limited, to be increased. They want to increase the reputation of their business. So they might enter, they might ask a person who is more reputed in their town. Okay, let's take an example for this. There are two friends A and B. They are living in a country called XYZ. So they decided to enter a renowned person, a reputed person into their partnership so that they can increase the goodwill of their business. So the reason can be to increase the goodwill or reputation. This can be the another reason. Now, the last reason that can be for admitting a new partner is to increase the morale of the existing employees, to encourage the employees. Let's take an example for this. Suppose there is an employee in your organization or a firm who can improve herself or himself. So you can ask him or give him an offer to join your partnership, to join your firm. so that his you can increase her morale, you can encourage him to work better. So the next reason is to encourage the employees. So these are the reasons for which a new partner can be added into the partnership firm. The first one was for the capital required for expansion. The second one is when a competent or an experienced person is required. The third one is to increase the goodwill or to increase the reputation of the business. And the last one is to encourage the employees or to increase the morale of the employees. So let's begin with the next topic and let's move on to the next topic. We have discussed why a new partner can be added to the business. Now, the next is, what are the adjustments to be made at the time of admission of a partner? So, when a new partner is admitted into the partnership firm, there are a lot of things, lot of adjustments the old partners A and B are required to make. So let's begin with that. So these are the adjustments we need to make at the time of admission. So the first adjustment we need to study is calculation of new profit sharing ratio. So we will be studying this today, that how to calculate new profit sharing ratio. The second adjustment we need to make is treatment of goodwill. The third adjustment we need to make is treatment of reserves and accumulated profits. The fourth adjustment is adjustments of capital. And the fifth one is treatment for revaluation of assets and liabilities. These are the five adjustments that we need to make at the time of admission of new partner. So we will be covering all these adjustments one by one. And our today's topic is calculation of new profit sharing ratio. So today we will learn how to calculate new profit sharing ratio in different cases using different technique. So let's move on to the next topic. So before beginning the next topic, let us understand one more topic, that what does a new partner brings at the time of admission? A one mark question might come in your exam asking that why do a partner bring capital or goodwill at the time of admission. So we need to understand what does a partner brings at the time of admission, and also why do he bring such amount or such things. So let us begin the topic. A new partner brings two things at the time of admission. The first one is capital and the another one is goodwill. So, why do we bring capital? We bring capital to acquire a share in future profit. If a person wants to be a partner and acquire a share in the future profits of a firm, so what does he need to bring? He need to bring capital for that. So, he brings capital, new partner brings capital to acquire a share in future profits. So the another thing the partner brings is goodwill. And why does he bring goodwill? Because when does a new partner enters into a firm, the old partner sacrifices their share of profits. And why do they sacrifice? They sacrifice their share of profits for the new partner. And thus, to compensate the sacrificing partner, the new partner has to bring goodwill. So these are the two things that the new partner has to bring, and these are the reasons that why he has to bring capital and goodwill. So do pay attention on these reasons, that why is he bringing capital and goodwill. So now we will be continuing our main topic, that is calculation of new profit sharing ratio. So as I have told you earlier, that there are different cases in calculation of new profit sharing ratio, in which we will be calculating the new profit sharing ratio through different techniques. So we will be studying the first case now, and the first case says, when old ratio is given, when old ratio given means that there are old partners who have already started their business and the ratio that is decided between them is given. New partner is admitted for a share, but nothing is mentioned about how he will acquire his share from old partner. So the case says that there are two partners and the third one is admitted for a share. Suppose A and B are two partners, C is admitted for 1/4 share, and nothing is mentioned in question that how will C acquire his share from old partners, that is A and B. So this is the case, and now we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio in this case. So when there is nothing mentioned about how the new partner is going to acquire a share from the old partners, we have to assume that total profits, whatever the total profits of the firm are, equal to 1. We will assume that total profits are equal to 1. After that, we have to calculate remaining profits. What we will calculate, students? We will calculate remaining profits. And how we will calculate remaining profits is, we have to take total profits and we have to deduct the share of new partner from total profit. Suppose the C was entered for 1/4 share. So what was his share? 1/4. So we have to deduct C's share, that is 1/4, from the total profits. And the remaining one are the remaining profits. So the first step is to assume that total profits are equal to 1, and then we have to calculate remaining profits. Now from remaining profits, that is 3/4, we will calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So now there are total 3 partners in the firm, A, B and the new one C. So A, B and C. Now we have to calculate their new share. So how we are going to calculate their new share? So as there is nothing yet decided between A and B that how they are going to share profits in future, there is nothing decided, and also there is nothing mentioned about how C will acquire his share from old partners. In such cases, we have to distribute the remaining profits between A and B in their old ratio, because nothing is yet decided. So the remaining profits were 3/4 and 3/4. We will distribute them between A and B in old ratio. Let's suppose that the old ratio was 3:2. What was their old ratio? The old ratio was 3:2. So we will be distributing the remaining profits as 3/4 multiplied by 3/5. As A new share, that comes to be 9/20. Now calculate the B new share, that is 3/4 multiplied by 2/5, because what's the B old share? That is 2/5. So the B new share will be 6/20. That is A's new share, that is B's new share. Now what will be the C new share? Now we have taken the remaining profits as the base for calculating the old partner new share. But for the new partner's share, we need not take remaining profits as base, because the share that is given to us, this is the share of C that is given to us, this is already the new share of C because he is the new partner. So we have to take this as 1/4 because his share was 1/4. But pay attention here. The denominators you can see here are 20. And for taking ratio, the denominators need to be same. Only that you can take the ratio. So we need to make this 4 equal to 20 to take their
ratios.
So now we will be multiplying and dividing this by 5 so as to make its denominator 20. So this is how we make C share new share. So this is our final ratio. The final ratio will be 9 by 20 is to 6 by 20 is to 5 by 20. That comes to be 9 is to 6 is to 5. So students, our final new ratio is 9 is to 6 is to 5. This is the first case on how to calculate new profit sharing ratio. Now let us move on to the next case where we'll be calculating new profit sharing ratio with different technique. So our second case is when old ratio is given, new partner is admitted for a share and it is mentioned that he will acquire his share equally from old partner. So let's compare this case first with the earlier example, previous case, that says that in this case nothing was mentioned about how the new partner acquired his share from old partner, but in this case it is clearly mentioned, you can see it is clearly mentioned that the new partner will acquire his share equally from old partner. So this is different from earlier case as we have compared it. Now we will see that how to calculate new profit sharing ratio in this case. So in such cases where it is clearly mentioned that how new partner will acquire his share from old partner, we first have to calculate sacrifices made by old partner. So because it is clearly mentioned that he is acquiring his share equally, so we can easily calculate the sacrifices. So refer the old example, refer the example we have taken in the earlier case. A and B were two partners whose profit sharing ratio was 3:2. And the new partner C was admitted for 1/4 share. So A and B were two partners and the ratio between them was 3:2. And the new partner C was admitted for 1/4 share. And now C is acquiring his 1/4 share equally from A and B. Now let us calculate the sacrifices made by old partners first. A sacrifice and B sacrifice. So how much they are sacrificing? So C share is equal to 1/4 and he is acquiring his share equally from old partners. And how many partners are there? Two partners. It means that it will be divided in two halves and will be acquired by both the partners. That is, C will acquire half of his share from A, that is 1/8 from A, this is A sacrifice, and similarly half of his share from B, that is 1/8 from B. These are the sacrifices made by the old partners. So we have calculated the sacrifices. Now we have to calculate the new share. So let us take an example for calculating the new profit sharing ratio. Suppose you have 5 toffees and you have to give 2 of them to one of your friends. So how much you are left with? You was having 5 toffees and you gave 2 to your friend. So you are left with 3 toffees. So the same story is to be here, that A was having 3/5 share. What was A old share? 3/5. And what does he sacrifice? 1/8. So we just have to deduct the sacrifice from the old share. So we will solve this. and whatever be the answer is the new share of A. Similarly, we will be calculating the new share of B. What was the old share of B? That is 2 by 5. He was having 2 by 5 toffees. Let us refer to that. And what has he sacrificed? 1 by 8. So we will be deducting 1 by 8 from his old share. We will solve it. And this is his new share. 11 by 40, 19 by 40. So A's new share is 19 by 40 and B's new share is 11 upon 40, 11 by 40. Now let's calculate C's new share. As I have told you earlier in earlier case that for calculating new partner share, we do not have to refer anything because the share that is given to us is already the new share. So C's new share is 1 by 4. We just have to make sure that denominators are equal. So denominators are 40. And to make this equal to 40, what we need to do is divide and multiply by 10. And it comes to be 10 by 40. Now you can see that all the denominators are equal and the ratio will be 19:11:10. So what is the final ratio? 19:11:10. This comes to be your new profit sharing ratio in the second case. So that's it. We will be covering these two cases today only, and the next cases will be covered in the next class, and the remaining cases will be covered in the next class.